Hello students, today we see a new measuring instrument. Its name is screw gauge. So we will see pitch, least down and how to take an observed reading of a screw gauge and how to find the correct reading of it. So screw gauge, it is an instrument used for measuring the diameter of very thin wires or similar objects. Its accuracy is up to 0.001 centimeter. Means its least round is 0.001 centimeter. The lowest measurement which can be taken by using a screw gauge is 0.001 centimeter. The main parts of screw gauge are a U frame. One end of the U frame is fixed. So this part of the U frame is called fixed stud. Here fixed stud is marked by representing the letter A. So this is the fixed stud. The next part of the screw gauge is nut and screw. So this is that part, nut and screw. The nut is threaded from inside and the screw is threaded from outside. The next part is sleeve cylinder. To the nut, the sleeve cylinder is attached. It is a hollow cylinder. The next part is baseline. On the sleeve cylinder, you can see a horizontal line. This is called baseline. On this baseline, you can see the markings. The scale which is made here, it is called main scale. It is called main scale. And the first division of the main scale is zero of the main scale. After that, there are markings. You can see it. The next part is circular scale. Another name of circular scale is thimble scale. So, this is a hollow cylinder. This is a circular scale. It is a hollow cylinder moving over the sleeve cylinder. This circular scale is a hollow cylinder which moves over the sleeve cylinder. And this circular scale has markings. 100 markings are there. The next part is ratchet. Ratchet is attached to screw by means of a spring. When the flattened end, this is a flattened end. When the flattened end B of the screw comes in contact with the fixed stud A, the ratchet becomes free and makes a rattling noise. Now the next term is pitch. So this is the screw and you can see threads on the screw. The distance, so these are the threads of the screw, and the distance between two consecutive thread, is called pitch of the screw. Then how do we determine the pitch of the screw? In order to determine the pitch of the screw, we have to rotate this circular scale a number of times.
So we have to make the circular scale to rotate a number of times. Then we will see how much distance it moves. Distance moved by thimble or circular scale on the main scale, and on dividing distance moved by thimble on main scale by the number of rotations of thimble, we are able to calculate the pitch. So this is the formula to find pitch: distance moved by thimble on main scale divided by number of rotations of thimble. Suppose that when on rotating 5 times, when the circular scale is rotated 5 times, the distance moved on the main scale is 5 millimeter. So distance moved by the thimble on main scale is 5 millimeter, and the number of rotations of thimble is 5. So pitch is equal to, this is the formula to find pitch. So you must remember the formula to find pitch: distance moved by thimble on main scale divided by number of rotations of thimble, which is equal to 5 millimeter divided by 5 is equal to 1 millimeter. The next term is least count. So least count, the formula to find the least count is pitch divided by number of divisions on circular scale. So the total number of divisions on this circular scale is 100. And the pitch is 1 millimeter. Therefore, least count is equal to 1 millimeter upon 100, which is equal to 0.01 millimeter. Now, we will see how to take the measurement of an object with the help of a screw gauge. So, first of all, suppose that you have to measure the diameter of a wire by using a screw gauge. Then you have to keep the wire between the fixed stud and movable stud and make it tight. Now, suppose that after keeping the wire, the reading which is shown by the screw gauge is this one. So this is the main scale reading. Suppose this is the main scale reading. So on main scale, how many divisions can be seen? You can see first division on the main scale is 0. After that, how many divisions can be seen? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 divisions can be seen. So main scale reading is equal to 5 millimeter. And now we have to see what is the circular scale reading. In order to see the circular division, circular scale division coinciding, you see which circular scale division coincide with the baseline. You see, this is 50, this is 55, then 56, 57. So, 57th circular scale division is coinciding. 57th circular scale division is coinciding with the main scale, with the baseline. So, circular scale reading is, the formula to find circular scale reading is circular scale division coinciding into least count. So circular scale division coinciding is 57. So 57 into least count is 0.01 millimeter. 57 into 0.01 millimeter is equal to 0.57 millimeter. Then observed reading is equal to main scale reading plus circular scale reading. The main scale reading is 5 millimeter. And circular scale reading is 0.57 millimeter. So observed reading will be 5 millimeter plus 0.57 millimeter. 5 plus 0.57, 5.57 millimeter. Now the next topic is zero error. In order to check the zero error, by rotating the ratchet, you have to bring the movable stud B in contact with the fixed stud A. On bringing the movable stud B in contact with the fixed stud A, if the zero of the circular scale, if the zero of the circular scale coincide with the baseline, then there is no zero error. And if the zero of the circular scale does not coincide with the baseline, there is zero error. This topic is very, very important. Zero error on bringing the movable stud in contact with the fixed stud. If the zero of the circular scale does not coincide with the baseline, there is zero error. And zero error are of two types, positive zero error and negative zero error. This is the case of positive zero error. On bringing the movable stud B in contact with the fixed stud, if the zero of the circular scale, if the zero of the circular scale comes below the baseline, if the zero of the circular scale comes below the baseline, here you can see zero of the circular scale comes below the baseline, then there is positive zero error. So this is very important. If the zero of the circular scale comes below the baseline, there is positive zero error. Now we have to calculate how much is the positive zero error. For finding the positive zero error, we have to see which circular scale division is coinciding with the baseline. Here fifth circular scale division coincides with the baseline. Fifth circular scale division is coinciding with the baseline. So this circular scale division coinciding with the baseline multiply with the least count. So it is 5. 5 into 0.01 millimeter, which is equal to 0.05 millimeter. That is the positive zero error in this case. Now the next type of zero error is negative zero error. When does a screw gauge have negative zero error? So this is also the same way. First of all, by rotating the ratchet, you have to bring the movable stud B in contact with the fixed stud. If the zero of the circular scale comes above the baseline, this is the baseline, this is the baseline, and this is the zero of the circular scale. The zero of the circular scale comes above the baseline on bringing the movable stud and fixed stud in contact, the screw gauge has negative zero error. In this figure you can see that the screw gauge has negative zero error. Very important topic. Now how to calculate the negative zero error? In order to calculate the, here you have to see which circular scale division coincide with the baseline. In this case, which circular scale division coincide with the baseline? 96th division is coinciding. So the total number of circular scale divisions is 100. So in order to find the negative zero error, the circular scale division coinciding with the baseline, you have to subtract from total number of circular scale division, that is 100. So 100 minus 96, 100 minus 96 equal to 4. That 4 you have to multiply with the least count. So here negative zero error is 4 into 0.01 millimeter, which is equal to negative 0.04 millimeter. This is the negative zero error. Now the next topic is how to find the correct reading. So first we have to find observed reading. Observed reading is equal to main scale reading plus circular scale reading. Then correct reading is equal to observed reading minus zero error. So in the case of positive zero error, to get correct reading you have to subtract the zero error from the observed reading. And in the case of negative zero error, to get correct reading you have to add the negative zero error to the observed reading.
So we have seen main points about screw gauge. The examination point of view, the main questions related with the screw gauge are: draw a labeled diagram of a screw gauge. So this is the diagram of a screw gauge which is not labeled. I have already told you the label diagram of a screw gauge. Okay, suppose that you are provided with a screw gauge and a thin wire. By using this screw gauge, you are asked to measure the thickness of the wire. Then what all you will do? So when a screw gauge is given, first of all, you have to find the pitch of the screw gauge. So, what are the main parts of a screw gauge? A U-shaped frame. A U-shaped frame. Then this part is called a fixed stud. Then this is a screw. Then this screw has a thread. The distance between this consecutive thread is called pitch of the screw. Then this is baseline. Markings are there on the baseline. So this is called main scale. And here there is a scale, circular scale. Then this part is ratchet. These are the main parts. When you are given a screw gauge, the first step is you have to find the pitch of the screw. In order to find the pitch of the screw, by rotating this, so you can bring this movable stud. When you rotate this ratchet, the circular scale will rotate and this screw move inward and it will come towards the fixed stud. So B moves in and this movable stud can be brought in contact with the fixed stud. Okay, this is brought in contact with the fixed stud. When the movable stud comes in contact with the fixed stud, this ratchet produces a sound. When the sound is produced, you have to stop rotating this ratchet. Ratchet prevents the further movement by producing a sound. After that, you don't rotate it. When the sound is produced, you stop rotating. That time, this B and A means movable stud and fixed stud are in contact. Okay. Then, you have to find the pitch, which means the distance between two consecutive thread. By moving the circular scale a number of times, suppose that the formula to find the pitch is distance moved on the circular scale upon distance moved on the main scale divided by number of rotations. Distance moved on the main scale upon number of rotations. Suppose that by rotating this circular scale 4 times, the distance moved on the main scale is 4 millimeter. So the distance moved on the main scale is 4 millimeter. How? When this circular scale is rotated by 4 times. So pitch is equal to distance moved on the main scale upon number of rotations. And what will come? 4 millimeter upon 4, which is equal to 1 millimeter. So that is the pitch of the screw. So the first step, you have to find the pitch of the screw. Then second step is you have to find the least count. So least count is equal to pitch divided by number of divisions on circular scale. So number of divisions on the circular scale is 100. So then it will come 1 millimeter upon 100. Which is equal to 0.01 millimeter or 0.001 centimeter. That is the least count. The next step is you have to find the
least one we have already found. The next step we have to find the zero error. In order to check zero error, the movable stud is brought in contact with the fixed stud. Then you see whether the zero of the circular scale coincide with the baseline. If the zero of the circular scale coincide with the baseline, then there is no zero error. If the zero of the circular scale does not coincide with the baseline, then there is zero error. And there are two types of zero error: positive zero error and negative zero error. And in the case of positive zero error, zero of the circular scale comes below the baseline. Zero of the circular scale comes below the baseline. And in the case of negative zero error, zero of the circular scale comes above the baseline. Then, so I have already told you about this positive and negative zero error. Then we find the zero error. After finding the zero, suppose you have to find the thickness of the wire, then the wire is kept in between. So you have to enter the wire in between the fixed stud and between the studs. Then make the movable stud tight with the fixed stud. Then take the main scale reading and the circular scale reading. Suppose that the main scale reading, after keeping the wire in between the stud, suppose that the main scale reads 2 and the circular scale division coinciding is 45, then what is the observed reading? So observed reading will be 2 main scale reading plus circular scale division coinciding into least count. Main scale reading is equal to 2 millimeter and the circular scale reading is 45 into 0.01 millimeter. That is equal to 2 millimeter plus 0.45 millimeter. 2.45 millimeter. That is the observed reading. Then we have to find the correct reading. In order to find the correct reading, we have to subtract the zero error from the observed reading. So that is, if there is a positive zero error, then that positive zero error must be subtracted from the observed reading. And if there is negative zero error, that negative zero error must be added with the observed reading. Then we will get the correct reading. So this way we find the, take the correct measurement. Okay, next class we will see with another topic.